Hey guys, welcome back to Grey Wolf TV, and we are with Ozark, brand new series. We've only watched the pilot episode 4 so far. This is going to be episode 2. What an opening episode, though. My God. So, okay, general idea is this Marty Bird has been laundering substantial amounts of money for this Dell, which I'm presuming is Mexican drug cartel. I nearly said Colombian. And his partners and his friend have been skimming. Got caught, even though he admitted to the fact that he was fishing. He didn't actually know they were stealing. And now owes $8 million back to the guy. Managed to convince him not to kill him and his wife and his family, even though they've killed everyone else and stuck them in barrels, and said he's told him to re-launder the money, even though it's already clean, because he wants to see if all the spiel that he came up with just off the cuff about moving down to the Ozarks and laundering, what did he say it was, 500 million over 3 years or 5 years? That seems an awful lot of money, firstly. And how the hell is he going to pull this off? Especially in an area you know nothing about and no one knows you. That's starting from scratch, surely. And the episode's ended with him taking their money that they had, which was just around the 8 million mark, just slightly short. And now he's told him to take that money and launder it in this new area and start from scratch. And the episode ended where they just pretty much arrived there. And the FBI are already investigating, not him, but it sounds like, if I read this right, his partner, who is now dead, was an informant. And they're wondering where the hell this guy's gone. It's just going to get super complicated. But that opening episode had such an impact, and his wife had an affair, that guy ended up getting thrown off the top of his apartment building, which was probably the best and most shocking scene in the whole episode, because I didn't know it was coming, especially with how they placed it, and it felt so real. Right, that's enough of a recap in case you haven't watched the pilot episode, and if you haven't, go watch it. Right, let's carry on episode 2 to see how much trouble he's going to get himself into.
You two are to plant yourselves here. That is your job. Everything we have of value is in that room.
Really?
Yeah.
You're not going to be honest with us, either of you?
Yeah.
What's our story for the kids?
What do you mean?
Well, they see this polite dance that we're doing in front of them. They hear the constant edge in your voice.
Yeah, they must know something's
well,
up.
Well, we could tell them the truth, Wendy. How would that be?
Oh, you know what, Marty? Gary was a father. He had 2 grown sons. I never met them, but I...
That's the guy who she was screwing, right?
And they have sex with people who they aren't married to. It happens. It's not unique.
I want you to think starter home. We got $20,000 to our name. Just 20. So please do not sign anything without talking to me first. And we are not husband and wife anymore. But you're absolutely right that I share some blame for this. I should have caught Bruce. I was in charge of the numbers. I should have seen it coming. And no, I don't forget, Gary. I don't forget how you emptied our bank accounts when you knew I needed that money, Wendy. You knew I needed it. In fact, the satisfying sound of your lover smacking the pavement is the only thing that gets me to sleep every night.
Brilliant. Brilliant.
It keeps me awake when nobody's...
I could give a fuck. I need a house. Get yourself together. Give your girl some water. I'll meet you outside.
Yeah, you got it.
Yeah, no need to go in there. Thank you.
Yeah,
you're not going in. How about towels?
No, we're
good. Just sit outside of the door.
I am an angel investor. I help turn around struggling businesses.
You intend to make money off of businesses that aren't making any?
Yeah.
In a roundabout way.
That's the way it works.
Get to hold on to 100% ownership.
In return for what?
Well, I would control the finances, the accounting. Sir, you are delinquent on your property taxes, and you got those tenants that are suing you. I think there's three of them, yeah?
Let that be a lesson to you.
Okay. Okay. All right. Well, where are you going? What about our business arrangement?
No arrangement. You rented storage for me. End of story. Old dog, new tricks don't appeal to me. Rent's due on the first, Skipper.
Not meaning to be rude, but it looks like you're dealing with a lot of hillbillies.
Dad's not happy about my major, so he's hoping I'll have some, like, come to Jesus summer and switch. What about you?
We're from Chicago. My dad's in finance, but clearly he's just cheap.
Three and I are going wakeboarding a little bit if you guys want to come along. Leaving in like 20 minutes.
Don't do it.
Dad said to stay here.
You're supposed to stay.
Three iPads and a Pandora bracelet. I've had it.
Titty bar?
Titty bar, sure.
Strip club?
In the lake area, and yet you still seem to struggle, and I'm wondering what you could do.
Plain Janes with a work ethic? It's my sweet spot right there.
Ain't no payroll. All 1099s, independent contractors. No health insurance,
nope.
Vacation time,
nothing.
401k, social security, sick leave.
$100,000.
Can you go more? 150, maybe 200?
Yeah, sure I can. Of course I can. Yeah.
Get out!
My cut. You're washing your money. What you doing, ain't it?
Oh. I don't think you really...
Hey! Don't you blame me, Mr. Bird.
2,500 square feet, not to mention...
Oh, looks okay.
350 feet of lake frontage.
Actually, it's under your budget.
Really? I don't believe it now. He's leaving.
So, wait, you want to remain in the house?
Sam.
That's my street.
I didn't have time to explain that to her.
I've got a bad heart.
Yeah.
I need a new one, but I'm 82, so I'm not getting one. I'm selling the place under the condition that I be allowed to live here until I die. How many kids do you have?
Two. Girl and a boy.
Now we're in a septic tank here, not a sewer line. She's gonna chuck her period plugs down the crapper. You're gonna foot the Roto-Rooter bill when the tank backs up.
I beg your pardon.
If it is, great. Let's call the decider to sign off.
Who?
Your husband.
It's very, very quiet. I take it out of season. Yeah, yeah. Oh, shit.
You college, any of
it? Nicked it?
Hey!
You fuck.
For what? Quiet, stop! What are you doing?
Oh no! Can't afford for any of them to get any more shit.
Seems your daughter and her friends parked a little too close to shore.
They're not her friends.
Yeah, and she didn't know that this boat was stolen. Joyriding's not usually
their own bullshit.
But trust me when I tell you, they can't afford to pay. And you're assuming we will.
That arresting the white trash that almost killed my daughter and extracting the truth is hard time consuming work. Is that this all comes down to simple run of the mill laziness.
Shut up, Marty.
How's that?
I have 1,150 miles of shoreline to patrol, and 8 boats. So, to those intent on leaving a light economic footprint, staying in the cheapest possible places, sucking the tit of this department. Well, if you're lucky that Charlotte didn't get mixed up with Ruth Langmore. She's 19, smart, mean. As a criminal, her potential's as yet untapped.
You have a picture of Ruth?
Yeah. Don't put down anything around her that you're fond of.
Oh! That was the girl doing the housekeeping. Oh, fuck!
Who cleaned up in here? Did you let somebody in?
No, I did it.
You did?
There's more than that in there.
Okay. Jonah,
out. Yeah,
come
out.
Come. Go, please.
Which is why you weren't supposed to leave. She's still at the fucking lot. Your fault.
Mom says that girl took something.
Oh, yes. I'll beat your ass.
Do I ask that much of you, Charlotte?
You can't. You can't just keep leaving that amount of money lying around. and expect to be able to mind it 24/7.
No, you do not.
That's oh, he's found it.
I've taken it.
Oh, relax. Shit.
Relax. Just tell me one thing, okay? What do you think you're going to do with all of that cash? Can't go shopping for some fancy truck or something, not with cash. IRS will be on your front doorstep first thing in the morning.
Shut up.
That's mine. And technically, I'm only responsible for
it. It ain't his.
Well, whose money is it?
You don't want to know.
His name is Omar Navarro. Does that mean anything to you?
No.
Oh, so you need to think this through.
Oh, so he found him.
Guy runs a drug cartel's a smart man. You wouldn't trust damn near $3 million to someone like you.
How do you know?
Well, he trusted me with $8 million. You guys need to know how big this mistake you're making is.
You yeah, he'll kill the lawyer.
Some drug kingpin's money?
I'm going to have to tell him that the Langmores stole it. At which point, he's going to find someone with your last name and start removing their skin until he locates the rest of you.
Disappearance of Mr. Bird and the redistribution of this money constitutes a good thing. You think the IRS radars up the 70-inch Samsungs?
Who's got the big mouth? Who's the weak link with the big mouth and dates the trashy women? They're going to come asking you for a little bit of yours, and what are you going to tell that person? You going to tell them no and killing me? Because don't forget, for all this to work, you got to kill me. And did you know that Missouri has the death penalty?
We're taking 20,000. Get 20. Tell Mr. Navarro the truth. You are a poor steward of his money.
I'll let him know.
I almost got that done, didn't I?
I just hope no one else finds it. That's teeth. Is that the bowels they got rid of him in?
He jerks his family from Chicago and $8 million from the bank, transporting both to southern Missouri. If he was scared of us freezing it, he'd just wire it into offshore oblivion. He needs that money for what I do not know, but it'll be illegal. And when I do, he'll tell me exactly how and where the cartels are laundering that money, at which point I'll seize it, all of it.
Have you thought about how we're going to do this?
We're not.
If I'm dead, we have something. It's simple.
He's considering it.
You take the kids today, and you live off the credit cards until the insurance company pays out, and then you take that money and you start over on Horseshoe Bend near Sweetwater Bluff.
Ah, right.
Can you say that? Okay.
Sure.
That's what we're gonna find.
I think he just wants to know how often the claim is paid out after the investigation.
Not very often.
But if it's an actual accident, if it's a car accident, if it's...
Say he's maybe had recent financial problems or demonstrated unusual behavior, like
you.
Quitting his job suddenly.
And up and moving.
Or if maybe he had a spouse who'd been unfaithful.
Oh, I didn't even thought of that one.
Yes, I know. I'm sure I'm worrying over nothing. It's just he doesn't know the roads here.
No, don't send that. Don't send that. I don't think he's going to go through with it.
She was about to send an email.
No, she was about to click send.
Good. I wasn't thinking straight.
No. You think?
Look, Marty. I know this angle. You invest. And then we go and we remodel some units. And I take a little more money. And then July rolls around, a little more money. But it's advertising for the 4th. And it's better than nothing, but it's still not enough to service the debt on the loan I already owe the bank. And then before you know it, it's Labor Day. And I'm in hock to you and the bank. I don't need you for that, Marty, because I can fuck things up all by myself.
Top of me.
So get out. Now.
You are, without a doubt, the biggest retard I've ever seen.
You're not supposed to say that anymore.
Don't use that word. What the hell's the matter with you?
Yeah, you're not supposed to say
something
that,
to me? You can't use that word, ever.
Tell me what I can and can't say.
Yeah, I give that lesson to my kids, I get it right away. I mean, why does he have to feel bad just so you can feel good? Plus, when you disrespect him, you disrespect this whole place.
This I won't tolerate it.
You won't tolerate it.
That's right.
Now, I want you to apologize to that young man right now.
Smack.
You're miserable.
It's coming.
Redneck. Cocksucker. Yeah.
That is Buddy Diker.
Who?
Mr. Diker will be living in the basement. Your father's laundering money for a Mexican drug cartel.
What the shit?
I shit you not. Hello, Mr. Diker.
Okay. That was episode 2 of Ozark. I'm still laughing. I'm in shock. Why? She just said that like she was telling him what was for tea. Oh, by the way, your dad launders money from a Mexican drug cartel. That was it. Just deadpan. As it is. Straight to the point. Well, if the kids didn't know, they do now. He's gonna lose his fucking mind when he finds out what she's just told him. But I will say this. In the circumstances that they're in, and where they are, and how it's going, maybe it's not a bad thing. And maybe had they known that at the beginning of this episode, when it's showing them first arrive here, the daughter might not have left the goddamn hotel room unattended to end up leaving it the responsibility of her little brother, who also then feels as though he's the one that's been left to deal with it. And he went for a little bit of a walkabout, and he didn't go for that long. She went for the whole day and got in a shit ton of trouble with some dumbass redneck lad. I thought that didn't make sense when he said, oh, my dad's a lawyer, because of the job that he was doing. But I thought, well, maybe his dad's making him learn the hard way. And then when I saw the bow, I'm like, well, that's obviously his dad's. No. None of it is. Right then. That scene in the bar was all for her benefit. Whether that works or not, I don't know, but he's got a punch in the mouth for trying. But the important thing in this was he was considering out, as in, but it's not going to work. There's absolutely no way he could do anything to go out of this world that would not make it look like to an insurance company that there's something fishy. Especially as that private investigator that he was spoken to, the one who was he was dealing with for his wife, pointed it out exactly. They will investigate, especially if it's an individual, and especially if there's unusual circumstances, like someone might have just quit their job, or closed their business down, or emptied their bank account, or moved across state, sold their house, or moved in 2 days, and possibly found out that their wife was having an affair. Tick all of the above. She won't get a penny. And thank God he changed his mind. She was literally about to press the send button and inform Dell. That was damn close. Not thinking straight. Absolutely not thinking straight. And what he managed to pull with, what was her name again? The blonde-haired girl. The one I like. Ruth. She seems pretty smart. Very street smart. Her brothers all look a bit the usual. And he talked all of them. I don't know how much was in that one suitcase, but it's got to have been a good few $100,000. And he talked them out of being, one, at gunpoint, and two, into taking any of it other than what they classed as a nominal fee for their trouble, which was 20 grand, which, in the circumstances, I think is why he let it go. But she seems the smart one in that family, and I like her because she's blonde and she's pretty and she's got a sudden drop. That does it for me. That was a really good episode. I enjoyed it. I like the intensity. They keep the intensity up all the time. So they found a house, but they're sharing it with this old guy. But I suppose at least we didn't get to hear how much the house cost, but he said it was under what she'd said their budget was. So that helps. But at the moment, still, we're two episodes in. They've been here, what, maybe a day or two? And he's hidden the money. And so far hasn't managed to find a single person or business who's interested whatsoever. She might be at this Blue Cat Lodge thing after the little show that he put on, but we won't find out till the next episode, I guess. That strip club guy. It's fairly obvious why the club isn't very busy. But he knew exactly. The minute he walked through the door and he started talking to him, he knew what the score was. Which tells me it's been done before. And maybe somebody else has come along before and tried to do this, or some other type of individual similar to him, and that's why none of these businesses are interested. But at the same time, one at the moment, it looks like they're out of season. Summer hasn't arrived yet. So they're all in like low-key mode. Not really got any business coming in out, any clients coming out. They're just ticking over. And a lot of them are on the older side, the senior side. A lot of the owners we saw were all like 50s, 60s, possibly even older, who are not going to change their ways and have someone come in and interfere with their business in any way, because they've probably been running it that way their whole life and they don't want anyone else to come along. How the hell is he going to do this? I do not know. There's no way he can launder $8 million through that one business. That's not going to work. And now what he's going to deal with that he doesn't know yet when he comes home is now his kids know. Now he's going to have to explain all of that. He's very good at talking in round a situation to his advantage and laying out the facts. But I don't know what the hell he's going to say to them. Right, that was episode 2. I can't wait to watch the next one, to be honest. We've got to wait till next week. Right, we're only doing 1 week at the moment. This series is really good. My estimation of this guy, Jason Bateman, has gone way up already, and we're only 2 episodes in. I didn't know he was capable of this. Okay, if you want to watch this in full length, which I'm sure you would prefer to do because there's a lot going on in these episodes, it will be available on Patreon. The link will be down in the description. As always, edited versions will appear on YouTube and Odyssey. Link will be down in the description also. And if you're not already subscribed and you enjoy Ozark or any of my other series that are currently available on the channel, there's about 28, 30 different series that I've covered now. By all means, hit the like and subscribe. I would very much appreciate it. Post your comments down below, and I will see you for the next episode soon. Till then, guys, thanks a lot for watching. Take care.